Hello and welcome to 40 Days of Engaging Heaven. My name is Dennis Miner, Life Coach Dennis. Today we are going to, we are on the 36th day of our time of prayer and fasting and almsgiving, where we have been called by Jesus during this Lenten season to engage in acts of mercy, to engage in acts of service. And so our theme for the day is predestined to serve. Isaiah 49 verse 1 to 6, that's where we're gonna get our reading from. Islands, listen to me. Pay attention, remotest people. The Lord called me before I was born. From my mother's womb, he pronounced my name. He made my mouth a sharp sword and hid me in the shadow of his hand. He made me into a sharpened arrow and concealed me in his quiver. He said to me, "You are my servant, Israel, in whom I shall be glorified." While I was thinking I have toiled in vain, I have exhausted myself for nothing. And all the while, my course was with the Lord. My reward with my God. I was honored in the eyes of the Lord. My God was my strength. And now the Lord has spoken. He who formed me in the womb to be his servant, to bring Jacob to him, to gather Israel to him. It is not enough for you to be my servant, to restore the stripes of Jacob and bring back the survivors of Israel. I'll make you the light of the nations so that my salvation may reach the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord. And so Isaiah decrees these wonderful words to us. And we know that these are the words of the Spirit to us today. Of course, in biblical terms also, you find that this was a prophecy of Christ. Christ who comes with a sword in his mouth, who is the word, the double-edged word. And he delivers this mighty word to us, declaring to us that he has been predestined to bring us to him, to bring, "You are my servant in whom I shall be glorified." And you know, it goes on to, you know, these are the very words that Jesus also uses when he's just about to be crucified in John chapter 13. He mentioned it to his disciples as they are having their last supper. Now has the Son of Man been glorified, and in him God has been glorified. If God has been glorified in him, God will in turn glorify him in himself and will glorify him very soon. So I want to call upon us to understand a few things that heaven or God does in us that sometimes, if we do not understand, we may not achieve his purpose in this world for us. Now, number one, there is no person that is created of God in this universe that does not have a mission. As long as you are born with a mission. And so, as you are born with a mission, you are also equipped for the mission. Right from birth, from conception, you are equipped for the mission, because it is a predestination. God speaks to those things that are not as if they are. And more so, he tells of our end from the beginning, the same words of Isaiah. And God has allowed this to happen so that we can be able to achieve what he has called us to do. And so many are the times that many people will want to live in this universe, not understanding the mission that God has called them to. And a simple way to understand your mission, as I mentioned, number two, is to get to see or to understand your area of gifting. Your area of gifting tells you of your predestination, because God will always deliver to you the tools that you require to deliver the mission. So look around you. What are your area of giftings? What can you do better than most of the people around you? What can you be able to tell and say that is better placed than anyone around you? These are the things that have been equipped unto you that you may deliver. And so today I want to encourage someone that you have been gifted with many things. Are they serving the purpose of God? Are they serving the kingdom purpose? Are they serving heaven? Are you using the things God has granted you, has given you, gifted you with to bring his kingdom, to perpetuate his kingdom upon this earth? Look at the many God will never give resources to everyone. God does not do that, because in his kingdom there is an aspect called love. Love is our ability to care and to share. And so he will never give everything to everyone. So to some he will give wealth, so that they will have a gift of wealth making, so that they can be able to share with the others. Some he will give oratory skills, preaching skills, evangelization skills, so that they be able to disseminate the word of God and remind people about his goodness every single day. Some he will be able to give creativity, wonderful artisan gifts, so that they may be able to use their gift to beautify the environment, to beautify items around people, so that they can share that with the world. And so everything, whether it is a song that has been placed into your hands, into your spirit, into your heart, it is supposed to bring the glory of God wherever you go. You know, some have been gifted with a gift, and I am cautious, because some people don't think it is a gift. Some have been gifted with suffering. But their suffering brings hope to the universe. When people see them suffering and the hope that they emanate, they are able to find strength in the Lord. That you, when you are going through that suffering, that it is not the end. It is not the final word of your story. It is something that God will glorify himself through. Who would have imagined that Jesus hanging on the cross was a glory to God, was bringing glory to God, because he brought life to us. He paid our price of sin in full. So number three, we have to find ourselves not in God and not in others. You see, in service, the main call is not service. The main call is to glorify God, to have God manifest through us to the universe. And so, as we are going through our situations, it is paramount that we do not compare ourselves at all with others, so that you do not see what you do not have, but rather you see what God has deposited in you, so that you can be able to give it to the world. The moment you see what you do not have, you begin to pursue that which you do not have and forget your mission and purpose in the universe. And God's mission and purpose is different, that we may find him and be fulfilled by him, that we can fulfill others with the presence of God within us, and that he may be glorified through us. So this day, as we go through our time of prayer and fasting, God is seeking you out, that you live your life the way he has called you. You do that which he has called you to do. You remain faithful in your situation, whether you have or you do not have, whatever you think you may have and you do not have. Because many are the times when we are pursuing the things we do not have, we forget to involve the mission planner, who is God in our lives. And when the mission planner is in our lives, then we can trust him in whatever situations we are going through, whether they are a blessing or in our eyes, or they look like a curse in others' eyes. They can be turned around and be glorified, and they can be used of God to bring glory of God into this universe. So may the Lord encourage you and bless you as you keep on praying and fasting, and he will see you through every situation that you are in. God bless you. God keep you.